We are in Chi-Town, the Windy City. It's week two of the Big Three, and we got a couple of teams looking for their first victory of the season. The Ghost Ballers taking on the Killer Threes.
So you got some rest, but you know, Killer Threes is important. Last year they started off slow, couldn't win the first couple of games. And it seems like it's also on the start right now, but Carlos Boozer recognizing on the turnover.
Ricky Davis threw it away. Allen Anderson makes him pay with the mid-range.
Yeah, and part of the issue, too, with Killer Threes, when Chauncey didn't play last year, they didn't have a playmaker. That's why Mike James' role is so important. Yes, scoring the ball, but also trying to figure out ways to get his teammates some easy shots.
Ricky Davis.
You can't fall in love with, I think, three-on-three. If you open, you got it. But you got an opportunity to get a lot of two-point baskets, like right there.
I pass a lot, and he goes, that's kind of what I did in week one, as I found myself passing instead of being the aggressive Mike James that I'm usually in.
Well, last year, Mike, when he was with Tri-State,
Mark, get in
he put up a lot of shots. You know, and sometimes you want to be a distributor, but I think with this team, he has to be way more aggressive and looking for a shot.
Like that, Steven Jackson knocks down the three.
Yeah, we don't have to worry about Jack not being aggressive looking for a shot. He was never shy when he played, and most doubtfully he's not at all shy here. So Carlos Boozer knocked down another two.
Jackson has the first three of the night. Here's Mike James, and there's the aggressive Mike James.
I like that turn the corner. See, once you get open to a three-on-three,
you're going on the mark.
Stop, stay with him.
They're going back to Boozer. Back to the turnaround. Jackson lays it in. Steven Jackson drives it in, knocks down the short jump.
Puts a lot of pressure on the player to do that, but I like the ball movement a lot better. Nice little jump shot exploited the height right there with Allen Anderson over Mike Bibby. But
said he was definitely going to get after it today. Went 4-12 last week.
Wow.
Here's Meta World Peace for four. Got it.
I mean, it's going to take, you know, three, four, five games for the new guys to kind of really get accustomed to.
Here's Ricky Davis. He's got five on the shot clock. Just a 14-second shot clock. Davis with one. And it rolls in.
Get over.
Get over. Don't worry about that. Get over.
Into Boozer. Back to Bibby. Tried the and one. Can't get it.
What? To receive the pass to get a layup.
Mike Bibby spent 14 years in the NBA.
you know what? We talk about the Golden State Warriors and they're Delonte Divac, Chris Webber, and guys really enjoy seeing that backdoor pass. Backdoor pass to cut basket. Guys really enjoy playing together. That made me have, you know, I kind of lost a little love for the game up to that point, but playing with Sacramento brought all of it back.
All of a sudden, we're going back and forth now. Killer Threes just 2 points away from the half.
As a Killer Threes, you don't want to give up momentum. Right now, you're really dominating Ghost Ballers, and that's what you want to take in the halftime.
That one rims out. Bibby in the Boozer. Count it.
Keep it in their game plan and use that more often to try to exploit the defense and get some easy baskets.
Bibby with four on the shot clock in the Boozer on the roll. And he missed it. Missed the money.
The crowd letting them know about it too.
Allen Anderson, the kick out. Meta World Peace. Missed it. Anderson, got it. We go to the half. With the Killer Threes up 6, 25-19 over the Ghost Ballers.
What? I got the guy who started this all, Ice Cube. How you feel about being the United Center, the house that Michael built?
Oh, man, it's amazing. You know, just looking up, seeing the banners, seeing all the fans here that's excited, big-time basketball fans. Man, I'm happy to be here.
Now, you are a lifelong Kobe Bryant and Los Angeles Laker fan. Kobe, Michael, you gotta pick one. Both of them in their prime. Ice Cube, who do you pick?
I pick Kobe because he played for the Lakers.
Pick Kobe. Hey, guys, what do you think? Who do you pick? Thank you, Cube.
I love you, Cube. But yeah. Nah, partner. Nah.
Hey, win in Rome, bro. We in Chicago. Here's Allen Anderson.
Short
from distance. Missed it.
Right corner.
Don't reach, bro. Stay behind him.
In the Boozer. Boozer. Missed it. And
Had a world peace, laid you right up and in. Beautiful, Carlos Boozer lays it in.
When I took this down, last year was the last year they planned it.
Thank goodness.
What? You didn't like him?
No.
Mike James misses the three,
man. It's mesmerized opponent.
3 seconds.
Boom. And one.
Keep riding. I mean, Boozer is getting position inside.
Here's Steven Jackson. Action Jackson getting warm. Metal World Peace is a thief. Drops it down to Mike James.
But that's to come up with some key steals just as he did that last possession.
Here's Ricky Davis doing what he does best. This is a good matchup here. Davis. Jackson. Advantage. Jackson. Ryan Holland throws that one away. Ricky Davis makes him pay.
What they tell you, even in this, sometimes when you save the ball under your basket, make sure you get it to your teammate.
Jackson, the basket.
You got to check the damn ball. Let's go.
5-point lead.
Seeing the big three, there's rumors of Rip Hamilton, Paul Pierce, Kevin Garnett. I'd like to see all those guys.
6-point lead now. First team to 50. Wins it. You got to win by two. Here's Jackson. From distance. Steven Jackson's hot as fish grease right now.
But Steven, throughout his career, always gave you maximum effort. There's no different out here with the big three.
14 FO points have come here this half as Lee Nalon.
We need somebody's possession. Let's go.
Gets that one in the paint.
Right there. Move out, Ryan, move out.
Mike James, Holland, pick and roll. Ryan Holland. Here's Mike James, the kick out. Jackson.
Why not?
Why not? He can't be stopped. Steven Jackson.
Now to get the ball in Steven Jackson's hands to finish the deal on the offensive end.
Boozer.
Come on, man.
Knocks down the free throw.
The ball.
Here's Boozer.
If you're the defensive team, that takes away some intentional foul. You get to the free throw line, now you get a chance to convert to retain possession. So you got to be smart on defense, especially late game situations, not to give that opportunity to your opponent.
Boozer on a personal 6-0 run. Marcus Banks showing off the handle. Drops, lays it in. Oh, Marcus Banks. The turnaround.
Oh, no.
And there's the foul. Yep.
Coming up.
Got it. Inbounding with a chance to win it. Looking for their first victory of the season. Here's Allen Anderson. Ricky Davis. And here Allen Anderson knocks it down. And the Killer Threes get their first victory of the season as they knock off the Ghost Ballers by 6. 50-50, 44. Thanks to Steven Jackson. He had 28 points. 19 of those came in the second half.